Gamers, today we're checking the last series of round three, weekend number one, best of five semifinals of the winner's bracket versus B. This is the third time we're rematching. The first two times, it was a best of three. It was best of threes. I won 2-1, 2-1, and now it's a best of five. Let's get into it. So, the first map is Rocky Canyon, and again, you can repick the same sieves, and top four sieves are banned on each map. Now, I knew he's probably gonna pick Malians here, and I was debating what should I pick, and I was like, do I pick HRE? I haven't played HRE against this new style of Malian, but I was like, should be fine. So, I decided to go for it. I went 2 TC. And the game started off okay-ish. And you'll see what I mean. So he went with the, horses or scouts and all that shit. And this game is a good indicator when someone has good micro, how stupid scouts are. So he dives under TC, and look at that regen. Look at that regen. So he can go under TC, get a couple of hits, run out. Because it's just constantly regen. Like, with knights, you can't really do that, because once they take damage, they're weaker. So this, check this out. Why do I go for 400 stone? In case I decide to make a tower, I have enough stone to upgrade. I mean, you don't need 50, you need 37, I think. So I go for a TC. So look at this. Look how much damage they're doing. Spearman is actively hitting them. The villagers are hitting them. Look at the regen. He gets the villager, loses two scouts. But they cost only food. He goes in again. And look at this. Spearmen are hitting. And this would be pretty bad. Like, if these were horsemen or knights, this is pretty bad. Because they don't regen. But because they regen, you can just dive like a fucking baboon. And look at this. Look at their regen. They're just fucking getting insane HP. So he killed two workers. I think lost three or four scouts. But that's worth it for him. Look, he goes in again. Even though the spearmen are right there. I lost three workers while having fucking spearmen next to my villagers. What the fuck is that? By the way, these units are supposed to counter this. And now they just run away. And again, they're just going to regen to full. So now the playstyle with Malians is you get pro scouts, which you already got. And the reason why I built my TC here is because I wanted to prevent the deer stealing. But get ready for bullshit number two. You guys ready for this? I know he's gonna try to steal deer carcass. I know. And I still can't stop it. Look at this. I put my villagers in TC. He yoinks two. And because they run so fast, look at this. Charging spearmen can't catch up. He loses one. He grabs one. Moves one. And now they're gonna regen. And I literally cannot prevent that. So he just stole equivalent of 1,050 food there. So yeah. He comes, yoinks it. Yoinks this one. And look at this. Other scouts, because they're much slower, when they carry a deer carcass, the spearmen can hit them. The Malian scouts, they just outrun. It's insane. It's insane. Which, again, I talked about this before. I think Malian is not even a top 3 civ. And I would love if Malians got buffed somewhere else. But their scouts gotta go. Like, something needs to be done. Something's gotta be done with their scouts. Something's gotta be done. Alright, so anyway, the game started pretty bad for me, obviously. I lost three villagers, he yoinked three deer carcasses here, then he AFK'd a sofa, but these bad boys, let me tell you, they don't regen. So that's a dead fucking sofa right there. See, that's a dead sofa right there. I mean, it's gonna get one tapped after. After that, I did a pretty good job, like, picking off scouts like this. I actually killed a lot of scouts throughout the game. And because he took deer that were here, and he took, like, some deer here, and there's no more, obviously, then I was like, I'm just gonna go run to this deer pack and try to kill scouts there. And because he shift-queued and he did not expect, I end up killing two scouts, which I was like, very nice. So, with the how the game started, I felt like I was behind, but I was like, okay, I got some scouts, I did good damage to that one sofa, and I'm getting free castle. So I thought I'm actually in a pretty good position, but I just couldn't get my food count up. Like, I was just always lacking food this whole game. Like, I just couldn't produce anything. And I think that's because I didn't get my farms up fast enough. And I also didn't get enough value from the TC on deer. Another position of the TC I could have gone for is actually here. I could have gone TC here. I get berries. And then I could pull the boar to the TC. So maybe that was the better play. Because I felt like I'll put a TC on the deer and then I'll try to defend it. But he still took like 1,000 food from it. So maybe that was a mistake, right? And then here, yeah, I felt pretty comfortable, but like I said, my food income was pretty bad, and it was just not properly set up for this stage in the game. And I took one relic. Yeah, I got one relic, and I just couldn't get the second relic for fucking life of me. Like, he has so many scouts. He has scouts everywhere, so he sees the whole map. And I kept trying to... I killed his monk here. And I think I killed this one too, which was good. But I just... I didn't have enough food to produce. And actually, like, overpower this. Because if I had, like, five knights, I could have overpowered these archers, right? Because he doesn't have poison arrows yet. But I just wasn't producing fully. And, yeah, I don't know. The macro was kind of bad this game for me. I macroed pretty bad, I think. I did some harassment on the other side, but nothing too major. These fights are not going too well for me. And yeah, maybe, like, what he did here was, like, Omega YOLO, because he just has, like, fucking 20 archers and one sofa. So maybe I should have just gathered my knights and just mowed him down, but, you know, it's easy to say after the game, right? Coulda, woulda, shoulda. And from here on out, because the farms are like now kicking in, like this amount of farms, and it was kind of already too late. And now I run into a different problem where I actually couldn't spend the food because they didn't have enough wood, because I had to run from here to there. So I actually didn't have enough wood for production buildings. So you can see now I'm like queuing too many units. I decided to go for Siege Workshop from a Mango now because he had so many units here. But he pushes like right here just at the right time, and he kind of blocks off this area and all my production, and the game just ends from there. But yeah, yeah, hindsight is 20/20, true. And now he has poison arrows, so if I had this like Mangonel done here and my army was here, then I can defend this. But his army was like in the worst spot for me, so yeah. And I, in the end, I only got one relic, by the way. So that was also no bueno. But yeah, he played pretty well. I think the start was rough. Then he kind of was okay. But in the end, it was not enough. Because it just kind of snowballed from then on out. Second game was on Golden Heights. And this was a 53-minute game. Like, the first game, I thought I played not amazing. But I was like, I didn't play it awful. Like, I made some wrong decisions and stuff, but I feel like I didn't play it, like, I wasn't like, oh my god, I played it trash and that's why I lost, right? This game, on the other hand... Jesus Christ. So he pulls three villagers, he tries to do the cheese where He kills my villagers as I'm building, but Pepe laugh, I managed to get the dock up. And he goes for barracks. So here I was like, okay, I'm just gonna go 2TC Song and let him have the water. Because if I 2TC Song and he has the water, there's a timing where I gotta defend, but I should be okay. So I just age up. We're gonna speed this times 8, by the way, because this shit is a long. What do I think of this map? It's too cheesy, this map. I like the map, just the water is fucking cheesy as hell. But I'm not sure how to fix that. But yeah, I don't mind the map. Because basically it's all about, like, sometimes it's like if you pull three villagers and he pulls one, then you just kill his one villager and he's fucked. So this started with, I had a decision here. Like, do I bar, because I can't, I want a barbican here. I want a barbican here. Maybe I could even barbican here, pull the boar. So I was like, do I barbican or not? So my option was I get enough wood to build a archer range and then kill the spearman and then build a barbican. But I was like, fuck it, that's gonna take too long. So I just decided to build it here, which is not a terrible position, but I mean, you'll see, there was better position. I'll just say that. So yeah, like last game, I feel like he killed my three villagers because he microed well, because Malian scouts, and you know, maybe I was second off here and there. But this, just look at this. I was just like, what the fuck am I doing? I lost a villager. I think I lost a villager on gold, actually. I lost a villager here. And I almost lost another villager here. This. And I'm like, what the fuck am I doing? Because losing villagers to spearmen at this point is so stupid. So I'm already like, Jesus fucking Christ. So I do a counterattack here because I see that he has no units. He made a man-at-arm, but I managed to do some eco damage where he was forced to run around, which was pretty good damage. He's forced to make stables. I split these Jugnus so I can like harass more. So that was a good move. That was a thumbs up. And then I build a landmark here. Now this is the second mistake. So the first mistake is I should have built barbican here. Second mistake is I build this landmark forward because I thought he won't be able to push me that much. Like, usually HRE like go more for relics and they do push, but they don't like Omega Giga commit, right? Well, and I went 1TC by the way because I didn't want to die to man-at-arms in castle. So here I go for second TC once I hit castle, because now I'm like, okay, I'm making spearmen, I'm making crossbows, I'm fine. I did a little counter here, I kill a horseman, and I think here I go back. I'm like, okay, we're chilling. He's got the fishing, I got the 2TC, and soon I'll catch up with the workers. I go for TC on deer, which my deer were fuck far away. So this is where disaster starts. I took one relic from here. He obviously went Ragnitz. This relic was here. And I picked it up. And then, instead of just protecting it, I followed this man-at-arm like a fucking idiot. The third relic that I can get is here. Like, those three should be free for me. Somehow, I managed to not only not get this, but also I lost this relic after. Like, look how many units I have. I should be able to defend this easily. He goes to harass here. I lose this moment. I try to wall off, and he kills the villager. I try to wall off this shit like three times, and he kept killing my villager. I try to take this shit again. He just kept like YOLO diving with knights in like past my spearmen and shit. I'm just like, oh my fucking god. He kept diving with knights here, and I was like, oh. I was like, you know when you're playing a game, and I'm like, and you're like, I'm playing like shit. So here, meanwhile, I got a villager, and I made some ships here, so I actually killed almost all the water. But in this game, I was like, I'm playing like fucking dog shit right now. Look at these engagements, like, they're fucking awful. I'm losing villagers here, like, can't fucking get rid of the knights. And look how many units this has. He's like pouring in. So I managed to stop his fishing, which I think fucked his food eco completely. Yeah, he had no villagers on food except like four. So he goes in here and I'm just bleeding fucking units right now. I'm just bleeding units. Then he's staying here, so he kind of loses a couple of units as well. He yoinks the relic, and then he's gonna yoink this relic too. So yeah, the water... So yeah, the water, I kind of deny it. He has three fishing ships, but he had like 15, 16 or something, so that was pretty nice. Here he dives. And I can't really defend it, because if I move there with the army, he's just gonna turn around and fuck my army. So he takes this relic, and I mean, this was looking pretty bad at this point. But, killing the... I mean, look at his food income. Killing the water saved me this game. Because if he kept mass-producing units like he did, I would've, like, died like this. So, that kind of saved me and bought me some time. To recover. I went on deer on this side, which he did not see, so I actually managed to vacuum all the deer here, which was a much needed food source. Got some villagers here. I got one. And the game kind of slowed down, and I knew if I get this game to Imperial, I'll probably win, because I'm feeling pretty comfortable. I'm feeling pretty comfortable in Imperial. So, and by the way, that those demos were rallied onto the ships, but for some reason they just don't explode, they just stand there. Did I manually detonate this demo? No, it was right click. But yeah, these demos were rallied onto the ships, and sometimes they get to them and do nothing, sometimes they explode. So yeah, here I see his army, and I'm like, okay, I can get a good engage. Like, now I have a decent army. Like, that's 15 crossbows, 13 spearmen, I can kill the knights, I got nest of bees, nest of these nuts. And I start doing men-at-arm run-bys. So I'm like, yum yum. Get some villagers over here. He comes with springalds, and I'm trying to run. But there's no point running, so I just committed here for a full fight. I'm harassing here at the same side. I'm getting walls done, so I'm like, okay, I'm recovering. I managed to kill all the lancers, or the knights, which is nice. And I got all the deer here, so now I can just go back and kind of leave this area alone. He cleans up the harassment. I slowly started transitioning to farms. But the situation was not good. I'm 30 supply behind. And I am ahead in workers, but and he never reset his fishing, actually. He kind of just made a few more and that's it. But he does have four relics, which is pretty difficult to beat HRE with regnants. And but this thing that you just saw, the knights coming in and killing the villager, happened so many times in this game where I tried to wall and the knights would come at that time and kill my villager. I literally wanted to implode during the game from that. Look at this. So yeah, here he's activating the Sacred Side win condition, and I did not want him to put two keeps because that's gonna force me to go into trebuchets and stuff. So I was just like, fuck it. I'm going in, brother. So I got a keep down, and he target fires with the archers. I managed to, like, I'm just fighting. And even though he has more army now, I do a pretty good trade here where he did kill like 12, 13 villagers, but I killed his whole army. So this kind of made me more safe. On this side also, I didn't see just now, but I killed like a Mangonel and two Springalds, and I'm about to clean up all his siege. So I was like, that's pretty good because I have a keep in the middle and I'll decap so he can't recap. Because again, I'm trying to delay the game, right? So he reaches Imperial, which is not that big of a deal. He's not gonna get any instant value. I kept running by whole game, by the way. I'm not really showing it, but yeah, Palace Guards running around everywhere, killing stuff. I pull Marine Lord's mom over here, and she just, I mean, she just goes for it. Here. Rip. And yeah, like right now, I'm kind of just like trying to stabilize. I'm trying to, you know, not die. And I, at this point, I was feeling like, okay, like I kind of got it because I'm making more farms. And I was like, if I don't die in the next 3 minutes, I'm probably just fine, you know. So here I get the spearmen in a little bit as well. I don't know when he built that keep there. I'm getting boiling oil. We got palace guards chilling over here. Oh, so my spearman just went through and then he built the keep. Okay. I don't know. He had three this was really weird. He had three hand cannoneers patrolling here. I don't know why. Like, why not just put three spearmen? They were patrolling here whole game. Which was... no. So I go with the Spirit Way because I wanted to go into Fire Lancers. And now became the battle for gold. I built the keep here just in case he breaks the wood walls. Because he kind of turned like really passive from here on out. Because he went kind of like, as we like to call it, full baboon in like early cast. Like he was attacking, 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 attacking. And then he just stopped completely. And this keep ended up doing nothing, but... I thought he's gonna be doing run-bys and shit, but he never did. Ugh. So remember how he said I played pretty bad this game? Kick them. I mean, that was like a terrible loss for me. Yeah, they were clockwork bombards as well. Or, Mr. Beast. So now, he actually loses a bombard and he loses a culverin. And then he loses another culverin. And I was like, okay. I mean, I'm, you know, I just fucking lost five, Nest of Bees, but I just killed two culverins and a bombard. That's pretty good. He tries to mass horseman here and he just gets completely obliterated. Then loses a bombard. And I'm like, okay! Let the siege wars begin. He builds another keep over here. I build Imperial Palace. And I just start transitioning to Fire Lancers. I start getting bombards. I'm going to speed through this because this is a long game. If you want to watch it, there's a VOD at UCTV. You can check out the full game. But yeah, I just go for... He loses another cauldron here. And I think he loses this one too. Yep. So my four Springles were getting sick value. And I slowly start clearing this up. I went with the crossbow run by because he was not making any armored units, so I was just like, fuck, let him die. But yeah, the gold was becoming an issue. And he had bombard towers there. And I kind of needed to secure more and more gold and kind of break out of this cannon emplacement shit, which is not really a big deal to deal with. It just takes a bit, you know. I lose the Springles. I lose three Springles. Bombard stays alive. Meanwhile, I'm getting like all my upgrades and shit. Two keeps down. I think I go for the TC next. And kind of just like opening up the map. Another culverin goes down. And another culverin goes down. So I was sniping his siege really, really well. And he had some success with that on my siege, but not as much. Another keep goes down. This is a new one that he made. Meanwhile, I'm doing run-bys the whole time. I'm getting wood on the bottom side. And my farms are just, you know, pumping. Now, my gold was running out. So I actually needed to get more gold on the map. Right now, I have these two golds, which are kind of close to me. But I wanted to stop him from making gold as, getting gold as well, obviously, even though he had four relics. So this just turned into like a fucking... Yeah, I get a keep here. Oh, he tried to put a keep here too. So yeah, I'm just like destroying production here. And I thought like, oh, this is over. I went for the dock on this side. I don't know why the units just... Yeah. Oh, dude, this could have been so juicy. Look at this, the Fire Lancers.
Oh,
But yeah, I killed 98 workers right now. And I thought like I'm about to end the game kind of thing, but then it kind of switched and I was like, I can't really push in. I had to transition to ranged units eventually. This is where my push kind of got halted a little bit. But yeah, right now he is not mining gold. He's gonna mine it here. So my next goal was like to kill that. To try to kill that. And here he had a lot of land ships. He did like a land ship transition. And I had mass melee units. So I think this is where, yeah, I dropped a bunch of archer ranges. And I went for that. How funny is this? He's destroying a wall. It's open right there. Kick double. Because I vacuumed the other golds, I went for this one, which is like super, super close to him. And yeah, the game just turned into like a trash unit spam. The problem is, China, I think, is obviously a really good late game, but but Fire Lancer and killing villagers against HRE is actually not that good because of the Palace of Swabia. Like, look how many villagers I killed, and he's just remaking them, right? So I tried to open this up, but he rewalled it like immediately. Because I wanted to attack into the chapel, and this game just turned into like mass units. And now I'm pushing back because now his land shit horseman spearman combo is dying because I have elite shugunu, which are really fucking good. And I got spearmen, so I'm kind of pushing back here. You can see he's dipping in supply, his gold is running out. I did some towers here to prevent the gold mining. And he built the gate on the wrong side. What does that mean? When the gate is on the wrong side, that means I can go on top of his wall. So I do that, and now these units got more range and more damage. And I just put them there, just mow down everything. Put some on this side. Like, look how much damage they're doing, just killing the land shits. Boom. He had a bunch of farms here, which is kind of funny. Like, he doesn't have a lot of under chapel, but he's got a bunch of there. I put hand cannoneers now on top of there. And once I destroy the wall, so my units can, like, you know, pass through, I just put all the range units on top. I decided to go for the tower destroying, get the regnets. I did some harassment on this side. And I was just trying to get like gold secured, and so I can, you know, actually get more and more. I think this is where I transitioned into like spearman, fire lancer, hand cannoneer. And because I was mining gold and he wasn't, you know, he was then producing like crap units only, like horseman, spearman, and that's it. And obviously, it's harder to win against like a lot of range and hand cannoneers and stuff like that. So yeah, you can see like he just has horsemen and that's cool, but when you have this amount of ranged units, they kind of get better and better. He tried to, I destroyed a keep here and I went for the gold, he tried to get the gold, but I quickly stopped that. And yeah, here I had a really good position, by the way, where my bombards were killing the regnets. I had ranged units on both sides of the wall, and I just rallied all the units here to defend. I keep doing run-bys here for the siege, just trying to repair the regnets because that's his only gold income right now. I put a wall just so he can't re-wall. More run-bys over here. I built towers for vision and shit. And yeah, I got access to this big gold, and then I have this gold as well at the same time, so I'm just chilling. His regnets died, by the way. He repaired it, but the relics are not inside. And slowly but surely, we did it. Next game was on Holy Island. So if you guys, if you're watching on YouTube, if you watched the previous video where I talk about why I picked Delhi versus Garnath, because it was funny to pick Delhi on every map, and then when I picked Delhi on Holy Island against Garnath, which is teammate of B, and we played this matchup, and I won, and I was like, okay, that was pretty good. So I can just do it again. Well, didn't quite work out this time. Well, I think B played it better than Garnath is number one. Number two, my fish was fucking garbage. Look at his, look at his fish. All right, look at my fish. What is this? Oh, it's the fish? No, no, I didn't lose because of the fish, but it didn't help. I think I lost because I'm not actually even still sure if Delhi is bad here against Mongo. Or if I just, like, I don't know if I played his shit or his Delhi shit. Or maybe both. Maybe Delhi's still good. So I don't know. So yeah, here, the same thing happens like in Garnath game. He goes for, what's it called? He goes for Horseman. And I do a little wall. And then he tries to like burn my shit. So, like I said, kind of same slash similar game, right? But this time, my transition to Feudal was way slower, which I think what kind of fucked me the most in this game. Like, I had too many villagers in wood. I should have kept like 7-8 in wood. Instead, I kept too many. And my age up was too slow. And now he goes onto the land. He's gonna build an archery range. He's gonna start making fighting ships. And I mean, it's kind of at this point, like, I lost only one villager. Now over chop happens, kick W. And it kind of just goes from bad to worse. It's one of those where it's like I didn't lose now, but it kind of did. So it just kind of snowballs from here on out. Like, I don't have resources to build horsemen against archery, so I'm like trying to wall off and do nothing because I'm worried I'm going to lose water. So yeah. Yeah, that, like, that's a shit ton of units, right? So I'm trying to build my own archer range. I think I build a tower here, and I'm just trying to hold the water at the same time. And I actually had more units in water right now, but at this point, I end up... Oh yeah, so I lost three villagers. Okay, actually, I didn't lose any villagers there. Okay, so that was good defense, actually. I didn't lose any villagers. And I think I actually won the water fight. But then, you know, his reinforcements arrive. I'm trying to micro on two sides. I'm steering on both sides. My villagers are, like, running back and forth. And, this is where I start losing, fishing ships. Because I'm fighting with fishing ships. Oh. That was a bad one. I start fighting with fishing ships. He goes for the... Or not. Never mind. And if you look at the, if you look at the army and the thing, right? So I have 11 fishing ships. So it's not, so my army is actually 38 versus 55 right now. And economy is like 52 versus 58. So he's ahead in economy and he's quite a bit ahead on army as well. I actually made a barracks here as well, which was a second. So yeah, I'm trying to hold here. I'm steering. He finds my gold villagers, I get fucked. And then because of all the stuff that happened, I start falling behind more and more on eco. I can't really defend because my army is smaller, so he just starts doing my docks. And it's kind of like a slow death, you know? In the end, I tried to transition to like multiple TCs and like delay the game because... Like, best of fives are pretty long, so I wanted to just delay the game so that he gets tired or something. Because I'm used to playing, like, 8 to 10 hours a day. I don't know if he is or not. So yeah, here I completely lose the water. I tried to run by with demos and kill some fishing at least. And I do that. I get another TC, but I try to get another TC here, which he spots immediately. And I think the moment I left was when I saw him make... oh yeah, I saw Kurultai here, and I was like, oh, he's about to eat that. So I was like, fuck it. It's over. It is over. So yeah, I'm not sure if I just played trash there, or if Delhi's trash, or a bit of both. I didn't lose because of the fish. I mean, it's obviously a disadvantage, right? But it's... I actually wonder, someone should do a test. How much of an advantage is it? I'm actually really curious. If one fish is here, if like one guy is fishing here, deep water, and water guy is here, how much is that? What difference is that, actually, in food per minute? Because even if it's 50 food per minute, that's a lot, and it has to be, right? I'm not sure. But yeah, I didn't lose because of the deep water, obviously. Then game four, so I was down 2-1. Game four was in Dry Arabia, and I knew he's gonna pick Malians again because he plays Malians on every open map and he just goes mass scout shit. And I said, not today. Not today, brother. And you know what the funniest part is? I didn't even practice Abbasid for this round. I practiced some other civs that I didn't even get to play on the maps that I practiced them on. So I was just like, well, I can't pick HRE because my HRE got fucked. So I was like, Abbasid is pretty good. And I went Eco Wing. So my plan is to just go triple TC and then defend. And I had, to be fair, right, my deep water was shit last game, but this spawn was pretty good for me this game. Both of my deer packs are close to one another, which is very good against this deer stealing crap. And I was like, okay, if I put a wall here and I put a wall here, then he can't steal the deer. He's gonna have to go all the way around. So that was my game plan. And just look at this. Like, again, I generally don't know. Maybe I'm just balding and the other top players are balding about this. But I don't know if anyone sees this and they're like, yeah, this makes sense. So the scouts are chasing my fucking spearmen to kill it. And I have to run away because they will actually kill it. Right? Because they regen, right? So check this out. So I get three spearmen. And I'm like, okay, I have three spearmen, so I'm gonna be able to defend the walls. Oh boy. Oh boy, look at this. And I have a fucking scout. I kill one. Amazing. I'm Wally. You're like, okay, that's pretty good. I'm walling. Let's go. Walls are coming. Spearmen are coming. Oh, I wasn't next to the villager for half a second. Pop, 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 pop. Fucking dead. They're just running through spearmen. Like, look at this. They're literally just running through spearmen, getting fucked and fucking me at the same time. So he loses two scouts, but he kills two villagers. That's worth. Like, scout is 90 food. And I can't stop it. Like, I have four spearmen and a scout, and I cannot stop it. It's insane. What the fuck am I supposed to defend him with? 100 spears? Because you know what the thing is? Even if I had 10 spears, he would have 20 scouts. You know what I mean? So it doesn't matter. My villagers still die. Crazy. That's actually a good point in the chat. Warrior scouts don't get stunned by the spears. Kind of want Marillor to say it's a skill issue just to troll. Well, he is one of the main molders as well alongside me to the scout, so I don't think he would say that. They're fucking dumb. I love when Marillor just said I died to scout too. I mean, I mean, look at it. Like, guys, I just want to remind you, these units are supposed to counter this. And they don't. They don't. Okay, so I go for a wall here. Poggers. He starts yoinking. And I'm just fucking trying to save villager's life right now. I'm just trying to... Look at this. I yoink another one right there. He passes here. And I say... Ah-ah! Psych! He comes back. What do I say? I say, psych! Ah! So, I've killed 630 resources worth, and he killed 163. Now, he did kill two villagers, and he lost 630. Now, if this was like a normal sieve, this would be a pretty garbage trade. But, because he produces them so fast, it's 15 seconds, and because Malians have infinite food because of cattle, this just costs food, so it's not that big of a deal, actually. And he stole four deer. He stole three through this side and one through this side. So he stole 1,400 food. And I feel like that's worth it for him. 1,400 food, two worker kills for 630. That is, what, seven scouts? I feel like that's a good trade for him. Oh yeah, he tries to chop here, but I see it immediately. Because he tried to yoink the deer. So I push him back. And now I'm just kind of stabilizing. Sofa dies for one villager, which I don't think is worth it. And right now I am on 3 TC. This was actually a mistake. I didn't want to do this. But I actually use it for tower later. So it kind of worked out. So right now, this is kind of like a preparation for the follow-up for Malians. Like, you open with a bunch of scouts, you try to do as much damage as you can, you get the deer, and then you all-in because the opponent doesn't have deer for food, so they actually run out of food first, right? That's kind of the idea behind it. So I get a tower here, and he starts his push. I don't have enough units to defend yet because my 3 TCs are taking up a lot of food and now my economy is like slowly kicking in. But I got my production up and I'm just pumping 3 villagers at the same time. So he can't attack here because of TC. So he can only attack like here, maybe here, right? Obviously he can take the deer as well if he had any scouts. Does he have scouts? Oh yeah, he has scouts. So he goes for this. Oh yeah, oh sorry, I forgot to show this. So as he entered, I quickly re-walled this area, so now there's no escape. I'm not stuck here with you, you're stuck here with me. So I re-wall, which means no reinforcements. So now I just waited for an extra round or two of units before engaging him. And he's trying to break the wall, because obviously he can't run through here. I walled here as well, so he is like panic trying to break through this because he knows he's about to get clapped because he has nowhere to kite either. Like, it's not like he can kite somewhere because there's a TC right here. So I just go for the engage. I kill the donzos and then I target fire the archers. I mow them down and this is game over already. Like, this is he kills the deer here on the way out and yeah, this is game over. Like, he just lost his whole army and he's the guy that's like all inning and I'm the guy defending. So this is pretty bad. Like, as long as I don't stop making units, I can't really lose from this point on. So yeah, I just do that. I see like, okay, I try to counterattack. I see, okay, he's still making units. I scouted on this side to make sure he's not trading. And I just see like, okay, he's still attacking. So I just keep getting my upgrades because I'm mining gold also. And I'm like, okay, I see more units coming. So I'm like, okay, just defend and that's it. Soon I start transitioning to farms because this food is my last food and it's going to run out soon as well. And yeah, if you look at the armies now, it's 58 versus 52, but not really, right? Because my 58 are here and his 52 are here. right there. Like, there's like 10 units running across the map. So I have more units. My reinforcements right here. He goes for the engage, but my units are actually cheaper. And like I said, the reinforcements is right there. And once I transition to farms, my economy will be way better as well. I mean, my economy is already a bit better because of the workers, because he does have two pits that are producing golds for free. Or gold for free, not golds. I go for a re-roll. I'm just defending here. And once I started putting down farms, remember there are only 56 wood because I'm economic wing. And once the farms start kicking in, I mean, you'll see how much food I had. But yeah, at this point the game's over. Like, I try to take this because why not? I upgraded towers as well. He tries to push, but now there's like two towers, and if I put five villagers in each, that's so much firepower. He goes for engage here, which I get a good flank. And yeah, I'm just chilling hard now. I'm aging up, and I can still see the units come, like, all the time. So I know that he is probably not aging up anytime soon. And yeah, these towers are just fucking mowing him down as well. He loses the scout, so now his vision's fucked. And, I mean, I have so many archers, I'm killing javelin throwers. That's how you know you're not in a good spot. I go for the engage again, because I'm almost maxed, right? So I'm just trading, and I'm just producing units at the same time. I clean up here, and I just go for the counterattack immediately, because that was a pretty decisive win. My food per a minute is insane, because I have... how do I keep clicking this shit? Yeah, I have 48 farms, and the funny thing is, I aged up. And if I didn't start these upgrades, I could have aged up to Imperial as well. And I thought about doing it, because I was like, ah, the game's over. And I thought about aging up to Imperial immediately, but I was like, okay, let's not fuck around. So I just got the upgrades first. Like, for all my units, and then I aged up to Imp later. Yeah, I'm aging up now to Imperial. My units are Imperial. Castle. He hits Castle as well. Wait, did I not get Spearman upgrade? No. And, oh yeah, I got them now, never mind. And, yeah, we're fighting here, but, like, if you look at my income, like, I'm fully producing units, and I can't spend my resources. I got 130 villagers. I stopped gold mining here, and, yeah, now I hit Imperial, and the moment he sees that, he just leaves the game straight away. Overall, it was a pretty, like, clean game. I think the move where I walled off his army and then killed his army, it was pretty much game over, right? And then the last game was Baltic, which is the Mediterranean. Now, I gotta say, I'm fucking tired of water maps. Like, we got so many water maps. Not only I'm tired of hybrid maps, but I'm fucking tired of full water maps. And his two home maps were Baltic and Holy Island, which are two full water maps. So I knew that he's gonna do the Mongol shit. And basically, I had three options. I was like, I either go Delhi, I either go Mongol as well, or I go Abbasid. And I felt like he probably knows Mongol Mirror better than I do, because he's only playing Mongols on this map. So I was like, I should probably not get into that. And I just went with Abbasid, and I was like, I'm just gonna scout and react, and that's it. So this game got pretty all over the place. Starts off normal. I knew that he's gonna do the horseman thing again, so I kept scouting for Uru to see if he does go for that or not. I kind of go here, nothing, right? And then I went to the corner and I dipped back because I thought he might make it when I leave, you know? So I come back and I'm like, oh, stables. So I go for barracks. I start getting gold because I want to age up. I don't want to make the mistake like I did with Delhi where I aged up too late. So, yeah, his horsemen arrive. I already have two spears. And again, like I said, I don't have a lot of experience playing against this thing, so I actually played it pretty bad. Like, I lost so many villagers. Because this is my third time playing against this, and it was all in the same day. And I always think like, oh, I have spearmen, like, I'm fine. But then I fuck it up, you know? Like, look what happens here! Did you see that? It's so stupid! He attacks my villager, and my spearman rushes to attack and blocks the villager, so the villager goes from here all the way around and dies. And I was like, come on. Come on, bro. Like, that villager kill was bullshit. That was not my fault. So here I go for the wall here. And I felt pretty good. You know, I lost two vills. One was building a dock here and the other one was on the gold. Which, again, is not good considering I have a counter for it. But it is what it is. He does lose, like, every horseman, basically. I went culture wing. And now the water battle begin. Water battles. So he gets more harassment, he kills another villager for a total of four. Oh yeah, I lost one villager here because I tried to make a dock, I think, somewhere here. I'm gonna speed up now. There's basically a bunch of harassment happening everywhere. I lose another villager and, like, yeah, I'm just playing it like shit again. So I lost seven villagers. Well. And economically, I'm behind. So I'm just trying to survive. He's doing the land aggression again. So, yeah, my plan is to just, like, play normal water game while defending the land at the same time. And I think he goes, oh, he goes through here, right? And then later he goes around to destroy this side. So there's gonna be a lot of water battles, a lot of microing. He picks up a fishing ship here and there. Did he get the bounty thing? Oh, he did. So he's getting resources every time he kills my ships. Alright. Wait. Wait, if he shoots at a demo and then I explode it, does he get resources? What the fuck is bullshit? Yo, what the fuck? But anyway, he goes for a push here. I got a tower here, amazing. He tries to make a tower on my gate. Doesn't work. And, I mean, you can see I'm slightly behind. I can't defend archers, so I just bail all the way over here. He has more units. And, I built another tower here because I was like, he's gonna dive onto the gold next. Oh, this is the moment. I attack through the middle, but the demos show up from there, and from there. What is Cutie Patootie gonna do? Split Cutie engaged. Actually, not bad. Not bad. I end up losing same amount as he did, actually. I ended up retreating. Oh yeah, so what happened meanwhile is he dove here, but he only killed like two villagers, I think. Maybe not even two. I don't think he killed villagers, actually. Maybe he killed two. And he lost like all the horsemen, Khan, and a bunch of units. But at the same time, I did a run by on his gold, And he lost, like, if you look, I killed 14 workers now. I think I killed like 8 or 10 villagers here. So I mowed down all his villagers. And then I saw that he transitioned to this woodland. So I was poking there. I move away. Like, his woodland is disrupted, right? Then he loses more villas here. Because he's not paying attention because we're fighting on water. And that finally, like, if you look at the economy now, I have more workers. Finally equalized the game. Like, I killed, you can see, like, 5 more here. Here, because he was paying attention on this, I managed to get a demo ship on these two. One demo for the two. Then I managed to kill them off, which was really good. And yeah, right here, I felt... I actually didn't realize that I killed this many villagers in the game, because I was microing on, like, 3 different sides. So here, something happened. I don't know if this was a misclick or what. But he runs his units, and he corrects them a few times. Like, he didn't click here and they just ran. He moves them multiple times. So I think he tried, instead of, like, going all the way around, he tried to quickly run through to attack this. But I saw it, so I intercepted it with all the ships. And he had, like, he has 12 units now? He had, like, 18 units or something like that. And I managed to, like, crunch him with the TC and the ships and shit. And he loses, like, everything to the point where I cleared up the rest with Spearman. So that was a pretty bad loss for him here. And very, very good for me. And now he is... He's got a bunch of Springhold ships. And, I still am chopping wood. Like, my villagers running back and forth was pretty bad for me, to be honest. I send these guys to his gold again. He's killing this, so I try to defend it a little bit. There was a lot of water micron here. So right now, I try to engage, but he snipes out all the fucking ships, which is pretty unfortunate. I donate 2 demo ships here because they're nice. 3 demo ships, actually. And now I had to bail because I saw his units come on this side and this tower was not upgraded. So I decided to just bail. I should have probably just upgraded this tower, I think. Yeah, I upgraded it now, but it's kind of too late. So I run all the way back, so I have no wood income. And I'm kind of steering now because of no wood income. I'm just pre-splitting and I'm waiting for him to attack me. But instead, he actually ages up to castle in a moment. My spearmen arrive here. I kill a few more workers, as you can see, because we're fighting on water, and he didn't see. Look at this. I got some good shots. I killed 2 Springholds. I destroy this, I think. And then I go back. And now, he decides to go for... he decides to go for castle. So I have all my units pre-split, and I'm just waiting for him to engage, if he is even going to engage. He goes for Kurultai. And what he does is, he actually didn't have a lot of gold saved up. He's basically got no gold. So I'm kind of posturing here to attack. Like, I'm kind of, you know, looking to attack. And then the moment I saw he aged up... Like, you can see I'm kind of poking. I'm not committing, right? So it's 19 Springholds versus 17. 14 demos for me versus 7 for him. And 3 archer ships versus soon 3 for him. So... This con dies in a minute. Oh yeah, I was transitioning to horsemen. I forgot to mention that. And I rallied them on the other side of the map for the gold. And I rallied some to kill this con because he was being annoying. And Kurultai finishes. And the moment it finishes, I just go for it. Like, obviously, I can't wait for him to finish the upgrades for castle. And he has no gold for them right now. So I just go for it. Full on. My horsemen are killing on the gold. 22 villagers before this, or 23. And now the connections start happening, brother. The con goes down. The horsemen are fucking eating his ass. The demos are coming in hot. And he has no gold because he's not mining. The horsemen come in clutch. He's not mining, so there's no upgrades. There's nothing coming. So even though he's castle, he just wasted all the resources. I'm pushing through. I'm like, I'm going in. I ain't pulling back. 33 villager kills. The fishing ships are going down. The demos are going in. Some connecting, some not. Boom, right there. He gets a sick connection here on like three of my, or four of my things. He gets another mini connection here. But I keep going, brother. I don't stop. His wood's running out, which means soon he's gonna need to run somewhere else. He has no gold. But he is getting gold from killing the stuff, which is good. And then there's only few units remaining. And you can see he's trying to produce ships to hold the water, because whoever loses the water is fucked with this map. I get a demo right there. He didn't even have time to get arrow slits, because he probably thought he was fine even though he has the stone. And then he kept making ships. Probably making arrow slits would have been better instead of making ships there, but he probably thought he can hold, right? So here I start mowing down docks one by one. I'm still doing some harassment here on the gold. And the moment, like at this point, I'm just putting a lot of workers on food because I'm trying to age up, because I don't want to like die to men-at-arms or something on the land. And I think he tried remaking the docks here, which I stopped. Wow. Amazing. With that game being over, or that best of five being over, next week I will be playing against Marine Lord in the winners bracket finals. So right now in this round I'm top three. This is going to be a best of five, and I mentioned this earlier in the other video, but I'll mention it again. Basically, Vortex, Lucifron, and Marine Lord are qualified. They are guaranteed in, and only top four qualify for the playoffs, so they're in. The Muslim has no chance of qualifying, because even if he wins, he doesn't have enough points. So basically, if I beat Marine Lord, I am qualified 100%. If I lose to Marine Lord and I lose here immediately, but then B or Wham win the tournament, they are qualified instead of me. But if I beat Marine Lord, or I lose to Marine Lord and then I win here, then I qualify. So yeah. If I lose and then lose again, but Wham or B end up not winning the tournament, I'm through again. So for them, they gotta win it, right? For me, it's dependent on how they do as well. And the thing is, even if I lose against Marine Lord, I drop down here. So if B beats the Muslim and Wham beats Lucifer, let's say, then it's B versus Wham, so then I'm gonna play one of them. So it might be like a qualification match, basically. Qualify for what? Well, so we had three rounds of Golden League, and now that's it. Those three rounds are kind of like qualifiers where you collect points, and then whichever top four players had the most points, which right now I am in the top four, these four will be going to the playoffs. And the playoffs are going to be best of seven, and then I think this is best of three, and then best of nine finals. For you guys watching on YouTube, I want to thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. I hope you learned something new. I hope you got some insight into these games, what I was thinking about. And if you're watching on YouTube, check me out on Twitch. I'm probably live literally right now. Right now. Check it out. Twitch gamers, let's keep going.